Kristin Peterson. My friends call me KJ, so it's Kristin and all you assholes. So I have some struggles going on in my life right now. I think the first one's pretty obvious. You know, my hair can't decide whether or not we're lesbian. Confusing for both me and my husband. But, you know, the other day my friend said that I look like a celebrity, so I was like, oh, cool. And then she's like, oh yeah, Justin Bieber. Okay, that was interesting. I was pretty pissed, actually, and the lesbian song too. But you know what, I mean, I don't look like Justin Bieber, so I didn't take it as like a full insult. You know, I have some assets, you know, a little badunkadunk. And let's be honest, like, my balls are way bigger than his. Yeah. I'm pretty sure everybody in this room has bigger balls. Sir, please don't check right now. So my other struggle is, you know, as Chris mentioned, I'm in grad school right now, and I also just turned 30, so I'm on the older end in grad school, which is a little difficult. You know, the other day, I walked into class, and everybody's sitting there, like, in those little awkward little desks with, like, a little half desk on it, with their laptops, and they're typing away like little T-Rex stenographers. I walk in the room, and it felt like the Matrix. It was a weird moment. Like, everybody on cue, like, looks at me, like, and then I just see judgment on their face, and I'm like, what is wrong with my Lisa Frank notebook, guys? So I adapted, brought a laptop next time, it worked out fine. And the other reason I feel a little old is with the language. Now, I'm pretty sure that you've heard people saying things like cray cray and YOLO, and I'm like, what does that mean? I have no idea most of the time, so I'm talking with them, and then, you know, like, they'll mention one of these words, and I'll just try to repeat and, like, nod and hope that's the right response. Like, YOLO, totally. And then, you know, I'm secretly, like, as soon as they look away, they're not paying attention to me, I'll whip out my cell phone, and I'm like, Google, help me. So I'm Googling, and I'm like, YOLO, and then Google's like, a plastic toy with string that bounces back to you, and I'm like, fuck you, Google, fuck you, Monica. But so I did figure out what YOLO is. For those of you also around the age of 30 or over, it means you only live once. So I've been trying to use it in, you know, appropriate times. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. The other day my friend was telling me about when she bought a plane ticket to Mexico. Last minute. And so I was just like, wait, you guys, wait, I got this. YOLO. And you know, after a nice little pat on the back, and they're just like, good effort. And then they told me that you're not supposed to announce it. So I didn't know that, so next time. And the other struggle that I'm going through is that, you know, along with being in grad school, I have like massive, suffocating student loan debt right now. So my life has basically become an endless stream of going to events with free food around campus. You know, I work it out pretty good. I put them in my calendar. I'm actually, just so you know, I'm part of all the political parties. Every single political party. You know, and it works out because, you know, the vegan bean burritos at the Green Party have no idea that I'm cheating on them with the burger and potatoes at the Republican. No idea. It's working out good. Walked into an LGBTQ meeting the other day. You know, my hair spoke for me. Easy. Walked into an AA meeting the other day, and that was a little weird, and then I thought for a minute, and I'm just like, I'm a Marine and a Millennial. I should probably be here. I started going regularly, actually. And then, you know, sometimes it's difficult, though. Sometimes it's difficult. There was one time where, you know, my little free food radar went off, bing, as I walked past this classroom, saw some food in there, just went in and started stuffing my face. Didn't even check what was going on around me. Somebody came up, and they're just like, are you sure you should be here? You're in the right place. Pause for a minute. I'm like, shit, all right. Time to get creative. So I look around the room, and I'm just like, yeah, something doesn't seem right. And then I see a sign off in the distance in the classroom, and it's like, the Jewish African American Cultural Alliance. And I was like, oh, fuck. But then I had a little idea. I had an idea. I just stuck out my hand, and I was like, shalom, my name's Rachel Dozel. Needless to say, she didn't really appreciate that. But I'm going to call it a win because I got some food. So I left satisfied. But you know, the struggle with the debt is, you know, it's gonna come to a good end. You know, 4 years of undergrad, 2 years of a master's degree, it's worth it. It's all worth it, I promise you. I'm studying international security, which makes sense with my Marine Corps background. And so my plan is, after I graduate, I'm gonna go to India and then become an Uber driver. YOLO, you guys. I'm pretty sure I used that right. So thank you very much. Please.